Game On is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports.
There you have it, of course, proudly brought to you by 1xBet. You can actually go online and drop a bet for a very subsidized order. And who knows, you could be the lucky winner and get yourself a very, very quick cash ante in there. And strictly for persons above the age of 18. And quick warning that it can be very, very addictive. Now, quickly, 3 days to the start of Match Day 1 CAF Confederation Cup football between Proline FC of Uganda, who won two big titles last season, the Big League and the Uganda Cup, will be representing Uganda in the CAF Confederation Cup preliminary. They'll be facing a side from Malawi that is in Masters Security Services FC this very Saturday. We still have King Ronnie in the house. Tell us exactly how that might unfold going forward. What can we expect from that affair this very Saturday? Now, Brian, I'll start with you. This weekend, Masters Security Services up against Proline at home, a turf that has become so familiar for these lads, a turf that has seen them get results against Vipers, against KCFC in the last recent months or years. And I want to believe that there is something different about this club side in Proline. Even when the manager in Shafiq Bissos in the dugout, yes, he wasn't successful at Express FC, yes, he wasn't successful at AC Villa, but he's finally found a place that he can call home where he can actually win titles. This Saturday, can they come out and go past this side from Malawi?
I think, first of all, the most important thing is the fact that, Proline is going to be playing at home. That in itself is a massive advantage, because what happens is that you've got the 12th man behind you as a team. All you need to do is maximize on that, certainly make sure that you can ride off some of the energy that the fans bring to the game. But then also, quite important, like we discussed earlier in the show, they're coming fresh from the CECAFA Kagame Cup, and that was a massive platform because you're playing against teams from the region, you're playing against teams from the continent. That allows you to be able to get yourself against some of the teams that actually could essentially be some of your opponents going forward. So that was a massive learning curve. The friend against Vipers, the game in the FIFA 8 against Vipers as well, I think that in itself as well is a very interesting game for this, Proline team. So I do want to think that they should be up and running, ready to go. It's going to be very important that they come out of the blocks, the better team in this particular game, because imagine a scenario where they concede quite early. Then that would probably give them quite the hill to climb going into the return leg. So they've got to stay very cautious at the back, stay fluid in the midfield, but then also take their chances when they get to come through. So it's going to be a very interesting game. I think for the fans and the friends of football, it's good to see a team like Proline, who have certainly come through the ranks over the years. A couple of years ago, they had one of the best academies and youth structures.
They still have,
so,
actually.
Well, they've struggled here and there in the recent couple of years. But I do want to think that it's good to see them going to the pinnacle of football. Mm. And, going to the continent is certainly very good for the players, for the coach, for the whole team all together as well.
Ronnie, I know right now the focus is on Saturday's game, playing in the CAF Confederations Cup preliminaries. But I would like to think, with the forthcoming UPL season, that should be another primary interest for the club side in Proline. You are back in the Uganda Premier League after a horrific campaign from the other season. Coming into this season now, is there a possibility, is there a reality that Proline could actually even come out and cement their place in the UPL and not even think about being relegated or even then finishing in top five? Because we've seen clubs come through from the big league. Ondu Paraka did that. Bright Stars did that. We also had, the other club side being Mbara City in Toro as well. Look like they're comfortable in there. Now that they're to spoil it for the big boys, can that be Proline in the forthcoming season?
Yeah, in fact, despite the fact that, yes, we are thinking about the CAF Confederations Cup, but our primary goal is the start times Uganda Premier League. And then the other primary goal is to stay in the league. Yeah, we all know how fans feel when you come into the league and then get relegated. Our fans and the players really tired of that, and they don't want to see that anymore. So what the management has done, the management has told the coach that, coach, yes, you're here, but our primary target
is to stay here.
Is to stay here,
and not compete.
Not staying here for one or two seasons, but to stay here, because we all know the opportunities it comes with when you stay in the league. It's always a very great platform to sell your players, to give them opportunity to play to the national team when you're in the top flight. You're seen a lot. The games are broadcasted on TV. Then it attracts a number of scouts to come in watch. We all know how the big league. Yes, it's one of Uganda's football leagues, but somehow disorganized.
Raw talent. It comes so much from down
but
there.
But because we are Proline, of course, we managed to maybe attract a number of journalists, a number of fans, maybe to come here and watch the boys, but we don't want to go back in that situation. So our target this season is to, first of all, stay in the league, and we make it a routine that we are part of the Star Times Uganda Premier League.
And not just staying in there, but competing favorably as well.
And I think we can do that.
Quick, faces that have been, you know, seen out, and the arrivals, you obviously mentioned Hamis Kiza. Who else has actually arrived at the club?
Yeah, we've made quite a number of signings, like I earlier put it out. We got a goalkeeper in Shafiq Magola. He came in to beef up the goalkeeping department after the departure of Saidi Kenny in the middle of last season. So he came in from Chiboga Young, very great goalkeeper. We did acquire the services of Andrew Okiringi Siaji. He is a right back, brother to Daniel Siaji, former Proline player now at Al Nassr in Egypt. We got him from Police FC. We did manage to resign. Why I'm saying this, because he has been here, Nick, I remember your time at Proline. He used to, you know, come in. He was in. Mukisa Yusuf, he was at Villa last season. He managed to come back, I think, for the third time now. We did get Bernard Mwanga, a defender. We got him from KCC. He came in on loan. Then, of late, we've got Alfred Leku. Then, Sula Sekamo, a left back from Paida Black Angels. And that is a Miss Diego Chiza, who managed to sign for 1 year from Vipers Sports Club.
Brian, those sound like solid signings for me. I mean, when you look at the experience they all come with, especially, you know, in all the departments, goalkeeping, defense, midfield, and the strikers, you get a feeling that Proline might just be that side that might, well, borrow the lead from Toro United and URA. Party spoilers in that regard. Shafiq Bisasso has an empire of some sort, building up from what he came with from the big league, going into the Premier League. You reckon they might just come out there and compete?
I think for me, first of all, for a player like Hamis Diego Kiza, he's still got a point to prove, especially playing at the top level. You know, with all the talent he's got, with all the potential we've always known that he's got, there's always been that thing where we always felt like perhaps he's never quite been able to hit the best of his ability. So I think for me, Proline gives him that opportunity as a player. But then also coming from the FUFA Big League, one of the things you want to be able to do is to sign already proven talent, which is precisely what I think Proline have actually been going for. And then also you've got all these tournaments that you're going to be playing in. The last thing you want to do is have a very thin squad going into some of these major tournaments, especially on the continent, because you need the quality, you need the numbers as well. So when you have all these stars coming around, I certainly it bolsters the numbers, it bolsters the quality, and it also gives the players a bit of competition for places, because unlike why you've got a thin squad and everyone knows I'm guaranteed to play and I have a place in the team, now everyone understands that I've got to fight for my place because there is a new arrival that wants to prove himself and wants to get into the team. So when you have all these things happening at Proline, it makes for a very interesting team, it makes for a very competitive team, and certainly it puts them in a situation, like you said, which is the primary target of staying in the top flight. It keeps them in that running. So when you put all these factors together, I can't wait to see how they're rabbit with some of the proven talents in the league.
Well, kickoff will be 4 p.m. Venue will be the Star Times Stadium, the home of KCFC, shared with Proline sister club side of some sort. And the fixture will be Proline FC up against Masters Security Services FC in the CAF Confederations Leg 1 preliminary stage for a place in the second round of the CAF Confederations Cup preliminary stage. Now, quickly, this very afternoon, we'll be having two interesting boys. That's, of course, Wakiso Giants up against KCCFC, the UPL reigning champions, battling it out in the FUFA Pilsner Super 8 pre-season football tournament for a place in the semi-finals to face Ondu Paraka, who did away with Toro United in a shootout. They did have Ondu Paraka claim it and score four shootouts compared to Toro United's three shootouts. Now, I'll start with you, Maroni. You've been following the Pilsner Super 8 competition, a competition that does kind of give us a cut and raise towards the EPL, rather the UPL. Okay, so Giants, we know what they did last season. We know what you did to them last season in the finals. Quick win tonight, rather this afternoon. They face KCCFC. Could that be like a test game for KCFC, who also have a game this very Saturday against the African Stars? Or do you see otherwise?
No, very good game for both sides, but I think it's going to be a tricky one. Wakiso Giants is one of the sides that have been very, very active in the ongoing window. They've signed a number of former KCCA players, whom I think, even if they don't play, still, because they are there, it will get into the players that will be given chance to play to try and prove a point. Getting in Geoffrey Serunkuma there, then Wanda Maweje into the squad, then the likes of Hassan Sinyonjo, I think it's going to be a hard game for KCC, given the fact that they are going to play at the Wakisha Stadium. So KCC, of course, winning the CECAFA with quite a number of young talent. I think even this afternoon, that is
might as well claim the win.
Those young boys will be given again chance to try and prove it here at home. When you tell me who will win, I think Wakiso, because they are home, they have a slight advantage.
Mm-hmm. Brian, Kifa Kisala's men have it all in terms of the financial muscle. We've seen them acquiring their new bus, obviously with the new manager in Kifa Kisala. They face a very good KCF side who have proven themselves domestically. They have a game lined up against African Stars. You get the feeling that they might be favourites on paper, but let's not rule out the beat of Wakiso Giants being who they are. From last season, yes, they lost the big league playoff final against Proline, but that doesn't mean that tonight, or this afternoon, they won't compete favorably against the Kasasiro boys.
Yeah, this fixture should have been played last week. Unfortunately, you know, KCCA had a couple of folks that were playing for the national team. So it was decided that it should be pushed on to this week. But that will also mean that it's the final game in the first round of the FUFA Super 8, because we've seen Onduparaka progressing. We've seen Vipers knocking out Proline in there as well. And we also got to see the same for, should be URA, or Barra City. I'm missing the other team. But it's going to be a very exciting game for so many different reasons. And for me, I think for Wakiso Giants, being the debutants coming into, you know, the start IMG Uganda Premier League, certainly they'll be facing off against teams with the quality of KCCA. So it clearly allows them to be able to sort of get themselves against the big boys. But for KCCA, I think the confidence has got to be with them, because after the beautiful run they had all the way to the finals, beating Azam twice at the 2019 CAF Kagame Cup, they'll be hoping that they can build on some of these performances and also carry some of this experience going on to the continent. I think for Mike Mutebi, he will choose to have some of the kids that did impress at the CAF Kagame Cup.
Quick one, Ronnie. No Agrema Doi in there, according to reports coming through from Wakiso Giants. We understand there are doubts for this game alongside Ayub Kasarita. How much of a damage is that for Kifa Kisala's team selection?
Yeah, I think not having the new signing in Agrema Doi will affect them, but it won't affect them so much because they already have Simon Namwanja
in there to replace him.
Exactly. One Fair of the enough. Left backs, I think, has been unlucky, but Wakiso signing him this ongoing window, this is his time to prove that, yes, right, I'm also there.
That's the game lineup this very afternoon down at the Wakisha Resource Centre. The first competitive game to be played at that ground. And guess what? It will be quite exciting for a place in the semi-finals of the FUFA Pilsner Super 8 pre-season football tournament, with KCFC set to use this encounter or this affair ahead of their CAF Champions League preliminary stage game against African Stars of Namibia. Now, still talking about KCFC, three signings have been made. And yesterday was confirmed Simon Serunkuma, the veteran, formerly at Victors FC, Express FC, Vipers FC, last season United, coming out to pen a two-year deal with KCCFC alongside Marevita as well from Express FC, putting pen to paper with the league running champions. Brian, I'll start with you, Ronnie. Obviously, when you look at the signings, for me, clear indication that Mike would be trying to, you know, blend the youth and the mature boys. We know him that he loves to play youthful football, and he banks a lot on the youthful players. We saw that in the CAF Kagame Cup. But here's a story of, once again, previously, Geoffrey Serunkuma, now you have a one Edisa Sekisambu, a one Simon Serunkuma in there. Do you think they'll do well at KCFC? I mean, it's not a long-term program, but you'd want to think their stay there might be a worthwhile.
Yeah, I think those three signings will do for KCC. Mm-hmm. Why am I saying this? When you look at Simon Serunkuma, this is one of the players that we've seen. He has the talent, but he has never lived up to the expectations, looking at the teams he has played for. And now at KCC, I think he has a chance, and under coach Mike Mutebi, because we all know Simon Serunkuma's lifestyle. With due respect, he's a very good player, but he has not been with a very serious coach like to handle him. But under Mike Mutebi, I think he has a chance to prove himself. Erisa Sechisambu is one of them, of course, who has to also showcase his talent. Being released at Goma here, he has got a chance to come at KCC. I think he'll help them. Then John Revita, perfect replacement for Timothy Awanyi. I think he is the best signing of KCC this season. Right. And to me, I won't be surprised if he comes into the KCC team and he takes over the defenders that are there currently.
Quick one there, kit launch, good one, bad one, fair. Your opinion of that? No? Does it matter anyway? The football matters?
Very good initiative for KCC, because we've seen previously a number of clubs have jerseys and they take long to change them. But because they've realized they have the fans, their fans love a lot to buy their jerseys, it's always good to always copy from the people who are better than us, those English guys.
Especially going into a new season.
You change in here and there, trust me, the fans will buy. Anytime. To me, it's a nice jersey, and it's a good initiative for them to do it. I urge them to keep doing it.
All right. Yeah. Thank you so much, Ronnie, for coming through, and best of luck this Saturday as we face on the side in Master Security Services. And that is, of course, the PR of Proline FC. That is Ronnie. What mentioned the other name, because I might bite my tongue. But yes, this very Saturday, they'll be in contention against Master Security Services Football Club side from Malawi for a place in the second round of the CAF Confederation preliminaries. Still to come, we have plenty lined up with the news coming through from the UK. Wayne Rooney in England for a possible signature with Derby County as a coach player. All that's still to come right after this.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.